I know I said in my last mock draft video that it would be my last one before the draft actually happens. Well, I lied, and now that we know the draft lottery results and we know which teams are picking 1 through 8, of course, besides who's picking number 1 because that team's yet to be determined, but that doesn't really matter anyways because whatever team gets that number 1 overall pick, I'm sure we all know who they're gonna end up taking. One thing I do want to say before starting off the video, this isn't necessarily my rankings on which prospects I think are better than the other, these are my predictions on which players I think these teams are actually going to select. With that said, here's the draft order, the NHL logo at the top representing a team that is yet to be determined. Then we have the Los Angeles Kings, the Ottawa Senators, the Detroit Red Wings, the Ottawa Senators again, the Anaheim Ducks, the New Jersey Devils, and the Buffalo Sabres. Without wasting any more time, number one I have Alexis Lafreniere. No surprise here, whatever team that loses the play-in round gets that number one overall pick, they are going to take Lafreniere. It is almost a 100% guarantee. All we can really do is hope it is not a team like the Edmonton Oilers. I mean, could you imagine Lafreniere starting off his career playing on the wing of Connor McDavid? That would be pretty ridiculous. I would also be pretty salty if a team like the Pittsburgh Penguins wound up getting him. They've had two superstars on their team for over a decade now, and they don't really need another one at least yet anyways. I'm really just hoping he goes to a team that could really use a player like him, like the Minnesota Wild, the Columbus Blue Jackets, or the Montreal Canadiens. Anyways, there isn't much I can say about Lafreniere that hasn't been said already. Everybody knows how good he is. We all know he's gonna go with the first overall pick. It's just a matter of which team gets that pick. So again, no surprise with him at number one. At number two, I have Quentin Byfield going to the Los Angeles Kings, which really shouldn't be a big surprise for anybody either. There are people that think Quentin Byfield would be a bad pick at number two with how deep this draft class really is, but I think it's only because he didn't put up, you know, 100 plus points like the Cole Perfettis or Marco Rossi or Alexis Lafreniere's of the draft. And he didn't necessarily have a good showing at the World Juniors either, but you have to remember how young Quentin Byfield actually is. He's still only 17 and won't be turning 18 until August 19th. And he still did put up really good numbers with 82 points in 45 games for the Sudbury Wolves. Quentin Byfield's ceiling is so high, I think it would be a big mistake not to take him at number two if I were the LA Kings. I just think it's a match made in heaven. I believe Kopitar would be a great veteran center for Quentin Byfield to learn from, and Kings fans must be pretty pumped with how the draft lottery worked out. You're most likely going to be adding a prospect the caliber of Quentin Byfield to your prospect pool that is already one of the best in the league. Again, in the top two, no real surprises, and it's kind of the same for number three. I have Tim Stützle going third overall to the Ottawa Senators, the first of their two picks in the top five. Now, don't get me wrong, I would be pumped if Tim Stützle did slip to number four and Detroit was able to draft him, but I don't see any scenario where he doesn't go in the top three. I honestly think there's more of a chance he goes at number two than number four. And when reading up on Stützle over the past month or so, there actually are some people that believe he could wind up being the best player from this draft class, which is some pretty high praise considering how hyped up Alexis Lafreniere is. I know a lot of Ottawa fans were pretty upset with the draft lottery results, and rightfully so. But after they do draft Stützle, if that is the route they take, and then they go on and get another good prospect in the top five, I really don't think we're going to hear too many Ottawa Senators fans complaining. And if I had to guess, I would say Stützle is probably NHL ready right now. While a lot of the other prospects were playing against people their own age and teenagers in the Canadian Hockey League, Tim Stützle has been playing pro over in Germany and had 34 points in 41 games, which is super impressive. Once again, not really any surprises at all in the top three. But at number four, I have the Red Wings taking Cole Perfetti from the Saginaw Spear. Now, again, remember, this is just my predictions and not necessarily who I want them to take or who I think is better than the other. Now, as a Red Wings fan, I'm definitely leaning towards hoping they take Marco Rossi. I feel like he's more of a home run pick and could potentially wind up being a steal at number four. However, apparently there are a lot of people within the Red Wings organization and around the league that strongly believe the Red Wings will take Cole Perfetti at number four, and for that reason, that is going to be my prediction. Again, remember, this is just a prediction video. I also wouldn't be surprised whatsoever if Steve Yzerman went with a guy like Jamie Drysdale or Jake Sanderson, who a lot of people are really high on. I think the top three in this draft are kind of set in stone, but after that, in my opinion, it's wide open, and I could see Perfetti going as high as number four or as low as six or seven. So that is my top four. And at number 5, I have Ottawa taking Marco Rossi from the Ottawa 67s. Now, a lot of people do have them selecting a defenseman like Jamie Drysdale in this spot, and while yes, that would be a good pick, I don't see them passing up Rossi if he's still available at number 5. Marco Rossi had more points than any other draft-eligible player this year with 120 in 56 games, which are some pretty insane numbers. Him and Jack Quinn dominated together. This would then mean the Senators came out of this draft with Tim Stützle and Marco Rossi, which again, I don't really think any Senators fans would be complaining about. And another plus about Rossi going to Ottawa is the fact that he played for the Ottawa 67s in junior and definitely knows the area well, which shouldn't really factor into the draft pick, but it is a bonus. When you look at the numbers Marco Rossi put up this year and how he absolutely dominated junior, it is kind of crazy to think that no one really has him going in the top 3, but that just shows you how deep this draft class really is, and pretty much any team drafting in the top 10 are going to come out with a really good prospect. Moving along now to number 6, I have the Anaheim Ducks selecting Jamie Drysdale. I think Anaheim and their fan base would be pretty pumped if he dropped to them at the number 6 spot, and I don't think he would really go any lower than number 6. A lot of people view him as the best defenseman from this draft class. Some people think it's Jake Sanderson, but I definitely think there is a higher chance Jamie Drysdale gets drafted before Sanderson for sure. 9 goals and 38 assists for 47 points in 49 games this season for Jamie Drysdale on the Erie Otters. He also had a really good showing at the World Juniors for Team Canada. He's a great skater, he has fantastic vision, I think he has all the makings of being a really good power play quarterback, and also he's already really sound in his own end, which is definitely something you want from a defenseman that you're say drafting in the top 10. I'll use a guy like Evan Bouchard for an example, drafted back in 2018, put up a ridiculous amount of points for a defenseman in junior, but everybody knew he wasn't really going to come in and make an immediate impact because his overall game still needed a lot of work. Drysdale, on the other hand, I think he's pretty close to being NHL ready right now, and I think he'd be a great fit in Anaheim. Next up at number 7, I have the New Jersey Devils selecting Lucas Raymond, who played for Frölunda of the Swedish Hockey League this season. And Lucas Raymond is somebody that I've seen as high as number 4 on a lot of people's mock drafts, and I think that kind of just shows you how unpredictable this draft could really be outside of the top 3 picks. In 33 games this season for Frölunda, Lucas Raymond had 4 goals and 6 assists for 10 points. Not incredible numbers by any means, but this is a professional league, and he didn't really get a lot of ice time either, as the Swedish Hockey League definitely caters to the veteran players. His draft stock has definitely been up and down throughout the season, but there really isn't any chance he goes outside of the top 8 in my opinion. The upside is definitely there, and I feel like I've said this a lot throughout the video, but New Jersey would be pretty pumped in my opinion to get a player like this at number 7. And now to finish out the mock draft, at number 8 I have the Buffalo Sabres selecting Alexander Holtz, who like Lucas Raymond also played in the Swedish Hockey League. He had a pretty strong season with 9 goals and 7 assists for 16 points in 35 games. He was also really good for Sweden in the World Juniors with 3 goals and 5 points in 7 games. When reading up on Holtz, a lot of things I've seen suggest that he could be potentially the best goal scorer from this draft class. I feel like him and Jack Quinn are really in that conversation. If Jake Sanderson is still on the board, that would definitely be a really tempting pick for them. They could use all the help on the blue line they can get, but then again, they need help everywhere, and somebody like Alexander Holtz would be a great option, or even somebody like Anton Lundell. And who knows, maybe they could go with a guy like Yaroslav Askarov, who is seen as potentially the best goaltending prospect since Carey Price. Again, this draft I think out of the top 3 is going to be very unpredictable, and I'm pretty pumped for it. As you can see, there are my final top 8 predictions for the 2020 NHL draft. Obviously, Alexis Lafreniere going number 1 to an unknown team, Quinton Byfield number 2 to the LA Kings, Tim Stützle number 3 to the Ottawa Senators, Cole Perfetti at number 4 to the Red Wings, Marco Rossi at number 5 to the Senators, Jamie Drysdale to the Ducks at number 6, Lucas Raymond to the Devils at number 7, and Alexander Holtz to the Buffalo Sabres at number 8. I am really excited for the draft now, definitely more so than it was a couple of days ago after watching the lottery. I'm sure a lot of you guys watched that video I made on my reactions to it. I was pretty upset with Detroit falling to number 4, but what I have to realize is they are still going to get a really, really good prospect. And I'm going to be excited about Cole Perfetti, Marco Rossi, Jamie Drysdale, anyone they pick. I'm going to be excited about whoever they draft, and overall I'm just really excited for the coming months. They announced the hub cities for the playoffs, Edmonton and Toronto, so I'm just really excited to watch some hockey, make some videos on current events as opposed to doing all like the history videos I've been doing and stuff. But yeah guys, that is going to wrap up today's video. I really hope you did enjoy. Make sure to let me know all your thoughts down below in the comment section. What would your top 10 look like? And also, out of all the play-in teams, which team do you think needs Alexi Lafreniere the most. And with that being said, if you did enjoy the video, please make sure to go down there and drop a like on it. That's the best way to show your support. And as always, if you guys are new to the channel and you want to see more NHL content like this, then be sure to hit that subscribe button, and I will see you all in the next video.